All right, the time is here. For those of you who were on the Bones 5 Kickstarter with Reaper miniatures, and those that missed it or those that ordered the Sophie's Revenge but don't want to open their box, I am going to do an unboxing of this absolute savage beast, 45-inch long pirate ship on my channel. We're going to take the parts out. We're going to let you look at what's in the box. And that's what I'm gonna do next. I'm gonna get this big beast off the table. I'm gonna get the parts out, bring them up here, and let's take a close look at all of them. First up, on the table, I've got all the little parts and pieces and accoutrements that will come with the pirate ship. That's what makes it such a great deal, getting it on the Kickstarter. Here is the gorgeous masthead. It's all molded in this gray vinyl plastic and some styrene. It is glued together with super glue or epoxy, but our beautiful lady, the masthead will go together like so. Gonna look beautiful on there. She's got two arms holding some of the most finely molded pistolas I've seen. Those are gonna go in her hands across her chest. Those look awesome. They got the triggers and everything in there. And then all these parts down here will attach her to the ship, and you can interchange the mastheads on this one. I already ordered the Grim Reaper masthead, and they do have other ones that are available. And she is that big. You can tell the idea of the ship coming up in a little bit. That is so cool looking. So that's the kind of sculpting and molding you can expect. Of course, that attaches her to the front of the ship, and it will be a friction fit, so you can interchange them based on the type of gaming, or if you just want to paint a couple mastheads and switch them out on your pirate ship as a display model. We've got some widow walks or crow's nests or whatever you want to call them. Check out the molding on those. Those are going to go up the mast. The ship has three masts. You can see they look awesome top and bottom. You can design them as you wish. Paint them up, weather them up, beat them up, chip them, scratch them, crack them, shave sections off like they've taken cannon fire. Really, there is no limit except what you can imagine. Look at the size of just the anchor on this beauty. Oh, man. I was so excited to get this, and it hasn't let me down at all yet. This will have all the parts key together. There's a specific way they can go, and they will all have shaped bases and plugs, and everything will go together that way, so you can't make a mistake, you can't orient it the wrong way and then it doesn't fit. The rope and the anchor on that beauty, get that all glued up, weather it. You can weather the metal here with the rope, you can weather the wood separately, and then the cleat and the rope, and then super glue them all together, or some 5-minute epoxy or whatever you want. We got awesome mermaid lamps for the back of the captain's quarters. Oh, beauties. Set those up so they look like they're lit inside. They attach with large attachment points. Remember, these are made for gaming, so they're going to be built super, super durable and able to take quite a beating, because people travel to each other's homes, they travel to events. My buddy Joe does this all the time, and he has to be able to take his armies and stuff back and forth, so they're not fragile like a styrene kit will be. They are actually designed to come apart and to be messed with and played with and to have games, but then they also expect a certain level of detail and authenticity, so they really get into making them look nice. Look at the ship's wheels there, and how lovely they look. All that detail molded in, and for the price that this thing was going for on the Kickstarter, you would be insane to have passed it up. Now, I don't know the name of everything on a ship, but I pretty much know what it does at least. These go on the deck, and that's where they tie off all the ropes to. So if you wanted to rig your ship and leave the masts in place permanently, you could also make it look a little more authentic by doing that. All these little doors where the cannon come out, these feel and sound like they're styrene. You get a whole bag full of them. You can hear them. They've even got ropes on the back molded in with the doors. So that is tight. That is just so cool. You know, I get excited about these, but especially pirate ships. I don't even know what these are. They've got ropes on them and pulleys. So tell me in the comments. I like learning, as long as you say it respectfully. Hey, Chris, that was so-and-so. That goes here. This awesome stuff here holes in the bottom, spikes on the top. I don't know what that is. I'll paint it up and weather it. You'll have to look at the box. There were actually no instructions with this thing, which everything is self-explanatory once you start assembling it. Here's some bases with rope wrapped around them. So beautiful. You're going to go through so much craft paint painting these up and weathering them. And that's why I like the cheap 50-cent, dollar and a half craft paints. You could go through 10 bottles and only spend 15 bucks compared to model paints, those little tiny tubs of model paint for gaming. You'd spend 200 bucks on paint painting this thing up, which is leagues more than you paid for the model. Gorgeous wood graining, rivet detail, straps on all these parts. This one's the same kind of a thing. And we're not done with the small parts yet. They still got small parts. I got a whole bag of cannon here. Massive amount of cannon. And they're two-parters. So you can get it painted up and decorated. Ropes. You could secure it with more real ropes around there to the deck if you wished. But these are able to be then moved as they game and aim at different troop movements. The barrels are right here. You could go ahead for a scale model if you wanted and drill that out. It's already got a hole. Get yourself a little drill press. Spend 40 minutes drilling out your cannon. Make them look nicer. But they all key together. And they push together. And you have awesome cannon. And the size of that for the 25 millimeter figures. You're going to spend a lot of time painting up all those cannon like you would on a regular styrene model ship. We'll switch to the other side of the table, which has some larger pieces on it. We'll get them out. Yep, we're looking at masts on this one. They are partial masts. You wouldn't want full-length masts on this, especially for gaming. But these feel like they're made out of styrene. They push together. And honestly, once you get that weathered, are you going to see that seam? Probably not. They have bases that they secure to. The bases have something heavy in the bottom. So I got to wonder about what that's going to be in a little bit here. But we've got like bowsprit parts. We've got sails that are all wrapped up. And you could make your sails, you could unwrap them. You could make fabric sails. But this stuff is really cool. Like it just shoves together. Terminates at the top like that. We got more attachment points. Large attachment points for sinking into some area of the ship. Rope details. Wood graining. Giant sails on these. I mean, the size of that thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It's 11 and a half inches wide. Massive. All interlocks nicely. I mean, I think that would go there. And then you can put that crow's peak up here. And all different kinds of parts. So put all those on the side with those. Oh! There's magnets in there. Okay, well, let's keep those on the side. They stick to something, but we're going to find out. This looks like it's the bowsprit that comes off the front. So you got that adds a good foot distance to the ship. So you got a lot of detail on that one. Because that one will have a ton of rope and equipment wrapped around it, because it has to support a lot. All your main sails and stuff tie off from that and go back. We got another mast here. Snap that one together. They all seem to be fitting well, which means they were molded beautifully. There we go. And they go together so nice. Look at that. Like a snap-tight kit. So that's cool. The sails go together nice. Snap, snap, snap. That's awesome. So, we got the big mass. We got these things that are obviously magnetic back here. We got the cannon. We got the smaller figures. I'm going to get the large hull pieces out. I'll be right back. All right, I got it on the table. I got to have the camera halfway across the room. Look at the massive size of the hull pieces. There are three main hull pieces that go together. They just click together. They just push together. And you really shouldn't glue them unless you only want a static display. Because as a gaming model, you can add all kinds of detail on the lower decks. And I'll show you how to work that. You can see where those cannon doors go on and everything. And I discovered what these are for. It's so that you can transport this savage beast back and forth to your games. So there's locations here where those rope tie-offs are. You can see the square holes there. the masts are magnetic and they're strong. They're like, I mean, they're really strong. So all three locations for the mast, we got one in the back here, back there, and we've got one in the front. So your mast can be attached and you can have it on there for your gaming and then just take them off when you go home. Now, we'll take the back off and let you look at it, the captain's quarters. That lifts up. You can have action down here. You can have action up here. You can have two areas to display during your gaming. That is so gorgeous. You could even light this thing. You could fit battery packs and hide them underneath the stairs and put some LED strip lighting in here and light that so easily. Put some tinted glass or plastic back here. Make your own stained glass windows if you wanted and show off a battle inside or just detail it to the way you prefer. If you want to make this a giant static model for the table, but the detail, the wood graining, I mean, that, oh, and how they got this in one giant piece, unbelievable. This is gorgeous. I couldn't be more pleased with this purchase. Honestly, look at that. And so proud, you can gild all that. You could, these are so big, you could even use real gold leaf and stamp it. You put rub and buff on there. You do your wood, you do your different color railings. I mean, look at the detail on the railings there. Outstanding. Let me set that back on the side. We got the upper hull and the lower hull. We don't have an entire lower hull, of course, because that would just be too big. And for gaming, they want a large stable base that sits on a table. So there are some caveats because it's not a dedicated scale model, but this is absolutely gorgeous and would take a lot less time to work on than like the USS Constitution. If you just wanted a really cool pirate ship, then you buy their other figures like I bought and you can state, you know, you can, I've got pirate figures, I've got ghost pirates that came with this that I ordered separately, but that are available in the same theme. You can put anything you want on here and make it look awesome, but you got your giant bow and that's where our beautiful masthead will attach. To the bow like so. You've got all that detail on there. The railings go all the way through. Look at the vents for the cabins underneath, for the lower decks. Black wash inside that. Use my black paint craft wash technique I've shown in other model videos. Soak in there. You won't go through a gallon of Tamiya wash or anything. It's got ladders on the side. It is insane. Lift that up. We got ropes coming off. We've got all that wood decking just begging to be weathered and washed, scrubbed by the crew. We've got the molding on the side, which is exquisite. We've got all these are usually like where the rat lines attach or the shrouds. I don't know what they're called, but they're all molded in there. You'll see some, there'll be minor warpage on these figures because it is a vinoplastic material. Okay, you're gonna see stuff like that. All you gotta do, if you experience that on any of these figure models, is run this under hot tap water, very warm water, but not so hot that it's boiling, and then hold it in position and spray it with ice cold water or pour ice cold water over it, and that will hold it back in the position that it was supposed to be in for the most part. It'll be back in there. You can see underneath, you got room to light underneath there too, plenty of room to run battery packs and lighting. You can even see around the back by the captain's quarters on the rear deck. It's even molded back there. They didn't skimp on anything. They didn't hide anything. And now you get the lower decks you can tear into and have action and excitement because you can take the whole platform off. You can decorate in here. You can hide men and women and pirates and animals and supplies and barrels and cannonballs and whatever you want. This will be your cannon deck through the doors there and everything. Move your cannon around for different adventures. So if you're a gamer, this is a must-have. If you're a big fan of pirate ships, this is a must-have. It's just awesome. Even has rudder detail on the back of the ship, wood grain detail. They missed nothing. Sophie's Revenge is absolutely outstanding. Reaper, you outdid yourselves with this monster. The designing, the way that it all interlocks, I think, is absolutely exquisite. I mean, it all just pushes in so you can always leave it so you can game it or glue it together, light it so you could see inside. This is the ultimate in cool. that the masks just stick on with magnets, so you can build them. You won't break them off. You can just take them off whenever you want when you move it around and go to people's houses. So awesome sauce. Now I'll have some still shots, which will give a little more detail of this beauty at the end of the video. And as always, thanks for watching the workshop. It's all about fun here, so I like any kind of thing that comes out as a model that I think is cool. I plan on showing some more of the figures later. Plan on doing a couple reviews just by painting them up and having fun. And we will see all of you at the next review.
Sailor, what shall we do with the drunken sailor?